Mercer's been here. I hope we aren't too late. Brynjolf and I found them like that. Mercer's doing. We have to catch up to him before it's too late. We should tread carefully. I wouldn't be surprised if he's left behind a few surprises.
Mercer will answer for this.
Wait a moment. What's that? It's Mercer. Look, down there.
I'm on it, lass. Damn it. There's no way through.
He's toying with us. He wants us to follow.
Aye, lass. And we'll be ready for him. Let's keep moving.
Hidden within these walls.
happens when you cross the guild.
It's a dwarven centurion. What was that? Enough games. Let's end this.
This place reeks of foul.
This must be their hive. We'll have to keep silent if we want to avoid drawing their attention. Even a farmer don't deserve the pain he did.
Practice.
Elia, when will you learn you can't get the drop on me? When Brynjolf brought you before me, I could feel a sudden shift in the wind. And at that moment, I knew it would end with one of us at the end of a blade. What's Carlyle been filling your head with? Tales of thieves with honor? Nocturnal doesn't care about you, the key, or anything having to do with the guild. Wait a moment. Do I detect a hint of genuine avarice from this noble thief? Perhaps Carlyle and Brynjolf misjudged you, and your true nature is no different than my own. It's clear you'll never see the skeleton key as I do. Instead, you've chosen to fall over your own foolish code. Then the die is cast, and once again my blade will taste Nightingale blood. Carlyle, I'll deal with you after I've rid myself of your irksome companions. In the meantime, perhaps you and Brynjolf should get better acquainted.
What's happening? I can't stop myself.
Skeleton key and the eye, and let's get out of here.
No luck there, lass. Something must have fallen on the other side of the door because it isn't moving.
Find another way out of here before the place fills with water.
Thank you.
Sorry, lad. I've got important things to do. We'll speak another time.
All that remains is to ensure the safe return of the skeleton key. I'm afraid it's not that simple. When the skeleton key was stolen from the Twilight Sepulchre, our access to the Inner Sanctum was removed. The only way to bring it back will be through the Pilgrim's Path. It wasn't created for the Nightingales. As a consequence, I have no knowledge of what you'll be facing. Brynjolf is an... And I'm afraid you'll have to face the end of... Take this with you. I've had this bow almost my entire life, and it's never let me down. I hope it brings you the same luck.
Hey, lad. I've got important things to do. We'll speak another time.
Ah, hello there, traveler. Come to the Night Gate for food or lodging?
Taller.
dig, Dwemer, when the top level was... I can almost hear them. I feel their life energy. Come, I will make the mixture.
Whiskers are freezing up.
What is this? It's just a book.
Come, my champion. Now, you have my Ogma Infinium. It contains the knowledge of the ages, as revealed to Sarces, my loyal servant. For hundreds of years, it's been shut away from the world. Septimus was a useful tool for unleashing it. Now, it is in your hands. Let us work wonders together.
Thank you. power of the Arch. So I gathered. It seems a certain orc has disappeared. Oh, you've got the writ of passage too, I see. Ah, and word has come in from Markarth that the keep's cook has met an untimely demise. You performed your duties to the letter.
I was wrong about you. Here's your payment, and a little something else as well, from me. It's called the Night Weaver's Band. I wore this for years. Now you'd better get a move on. See, Astrid, it's time. Time for the final stage of this grand and glorious operation.
It's been quite a boon, looking like a child. No one ever suspects a thing.
Yes.
So it's done. Oh, yes. And I've decided you will have the honor. Look at you. So calm, so confident. Go now to Castle Dower in Solitude. You'll gain unrestricted access to the kitchens, and then the Emperor. You're posing as... Here, take this. All it takes is one taste, and the effects are quite immediate. Once Mead has been killed, escape through the upper door and across the bridge. Now go, my friend. Go and fulfill your destiny as listener.
Being old's not so bad. Water keeps me fed. My working days are done.
Wanderer like you must have plenty of
things. City's calling the Imperial Legion. But you know what? I'm still nervous. Lazy and useless.
Stop right there. What's this now?
Order of His Eminence, possessor of these papers. The Gourmet.
By Azra. The Gourmet. I'm sorry, I didn't realize. But please, don't let me keep you. Proceed to the kitchen straight away. Gianna, castle chef, has been eagerly awaiting your arrival. Gianna will be overjoyed.
Not another delivery. The Gourmet? Oh, finally. It's just, well, you're an orc. If the people of the Empire only knew. I mean, now I understand your need for secrecy. Most would... Actually, you're not. Wearing a chef's hat, I mean. There's one right over there on the shelf. You can't very well cook. Out it. Oh, just look at you. Absolutely brilliant. Oh, yes, but of course. The Emperor has requested your signature dish, the Potage le Magnifique. But the cookbook only says so much, and everyone makes the potage differently. The base broth is already boiled. We can get started right now. So, which ingredient should I add next? Ooh, how decadent. What next? Vampire dust? Seriously? Yes, I guess I can see how that would add a more earthy texture. All right, what next then? A giant's toe? Of course, I'm sorry. What next? A septum? Ah, I see now. That would give the Potage le Magnifique a slightly metallic but delicious aftertaste. I have to say, the stew seems done. Add anything else and we may dilute the distinct flavors. So, oh? What is this? Some kind of herb? Are you sure? I'm sorry. Of course, all right then. And if I may say so, it has been an honor again. I'll carry the stew pot and lead the way up to the dining room. I'm sure the Emperor and his guests are dying to meet you. The Emperor's gonna love it. How can he not? Keep it together, Gianna. Keep it together.
Aren't you even the least bit nervous after everything that's happened?
You mean the wedding? My cousin's apparent murder? An unfortunate misunderstanding. Hold me. What are the tempers? These things happen.
Quite. Yet that recent business with the young officer. Now was it? How dreadful. The son of your commander plotting your assassination.
Yes. An unfortunate turn of events, that. But an isolated incident. And I have been assured...
Here we are. Gods, I'm nervous. We'll go in just a moment. Please, I'll serve. You just stand there and be amazing.
A befriending one. Now that's beneficial. As I'm sure you'd all agree. Aha! Here we are, honored guests. I present to you... the gourmet. Ah, the Potage le Magnifique. So delicious. My friends, as Emperor, I of course reserve the right of first taste. Oh, how marvelous. Just delicious. It is everything I had hoped it would be. I think something's wrong.
The gourmet and the chef have poisoned the Emperor. Get them!
What?
Let's get this over with.
That man was, by far, the most insufferable decoy the Emperor has ever employed. I'm glad he's dead. But I'm even happier that you killed him. You, an assassin for the Dark Brotherhood, just made an attempt on the Emperor's life. Would have succeeded had it been the real man. Surprised? So was I when a member of your family came to me with a plan. We worked out a deal, you see. An exchange. I get you, and the Dark Brotherhood gets to continue its existence. But you know what? I've changed my mind. How about this? I kill you, and butcher each and every one of your miserable little friends. Your sanctuary's being put to the sword right now. That's what I think of this deal. You killed my son. All of you. And now you'll pay the price. Kill him. Make sure there's nothing left to bury.
Here we go again. You can do.
Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense?
Smart man.
Tricks on me.